Case studies are ways of simulating experience. They're ways of simulating life. And in organizations and in business schools, they allow people to almost experience something before they actually experience it.
By the time my students get in my classroom, they're fairly well skilled in the technical aspects of finance. They know how to calculate a discounted cash flow. They know how to price an option. What students often haven't yet wrestled with, though, is the ethical aspects of their future careers.
Developing these case studies to focus students' attention on these ethically gray areas is tremendously useful for instructors, and it's really one of the more concrete things we can do in the classroom to support what's going on globally. Let's sit down and think about some gray areas that you might experience as a junior analyst when you go to your summer internships or when you go to a bank to work full-time.
I think the realism is extremely important, and so these cases are not something that faculty have dreamt up themselves. They came from the workplace, and because we have faculty working alongside these leaders in the banking industry, they've only become stronger because of this collaboration.
The direction it wants to give, the breadth of what it wants to embrace is very large. We cannot continue doing things in silos, organization by organization, and the fact that the Federal Reserve has the intention also to bring those cases and that type of education within the colleges that are training the future leaders of the industry is absolutely critical.
I hope to see a culture change in the financial services industry. We all have to have trust that people are following the rules, that we're not bending the rules to advantage some segment of the population or some individual.
How do we help our incoming analysts, our incoming junior talent? How do we help them to be successful here? Anything we can do to get them thinking about issues that they may be facing before they're actually in that situation is additive.
When I think about what the EIF is trying to accomplish, it is to help students and bankers meld their personal sense of what is right and wrong with their professional sense of what is right and wrong.